Hello, and welcome to another Star of Your Dreams videos. We've been working on some of the Anishinaabe or Ojibwe lessons of how to achieve what's known as the good life. And so today we are on to lesson number 3. Now, before we jump into that, I did want to mention that I really wanted to thank everybody that had questions, messaged me, comments, that kind of thing, to the video last time, and it shows the interest in. I really appreciate your support and your questions. One of the questions wasn't like a personal question, it was a more general question, and so I wanted to answer that more broadly. And it was, I'm very interested in your message. What can I buy? What are you selling that I can buy? And the videos are actually a way to reach out to more people to try to help address mental health and emotional health, maybe even a little bit of spiritual health, right? And so that's the main purpose. Now, I am a certified hypnotist, a life coach, a variety of things. So I can offer services that I do have for a fee. That's not these videos aren't a counseling session, so they're free. But if you did want something more in-depth, more personal like that, we can either arrange it if you're anywhere near where I live. We could meet in person. Or a lot of my clients, we do it over the phone, Skype, Facebook. So you can be anywhere. As long as you can speak English and we can communicate with each other, it can be done, even at a distance, right? So you could contact me about that, and some people did. I do have some hypnosis recordings that I do offer available for sale, dealing with things like less drinking, less stress, lose weight, better sleep, a wide variety of topics. Now, those are just kind of generic. They're not for a specific person, but they are for a specific issue. And if that interests you, you can contact me and I can send you to a website where you can see more of that. I also do, totally as an aside, but I'm a certified Sensei consultant. And I guess it's not totally as an aside. That's not the purpose of these videos. But I do use aromatherapy with some clients, especially with things like anxiety and sleep. Certain of the senses and odors can actually be very helpful when combined with other therapies, right? And so, and I find Sensi to just be a really quality product, and I love it. So for those that are interested in either essential oils or candles, waxes, scents, to maybe aid you on your journey, certainly I can direct you to my website for that. But the main purpose of these videos is if we think of our mind and our emotions and our mental health almost like a muscle, the videos can be useful to kind of tune in like you would to your body, see what's maybe hurt or injured in need of repair. Then you can use either myself or someone else as you reach out in an attempt to help repair that part of you that is hurting. It can also be used as a way to rest. Sometimes a particular muscle group might need to just take a break a little bit. And so the videos can be a nice way to break your routine every week, watch one of the videos, learn something new, and just take a break from some of your worries and stresses. Primarily though, I think that the videos, especially the weekly challenge, can be viewed more like working out, where you want to strengthen a muscle. So you already have your mental health. It may not need any particular extra help or healing, but we could all work on being a little healthier, a little bit more cognizant of our surroundings, aware of our feelings and those of others, ways to improve ourselves, always striving to be better. And that takes some working out. And so these videos can be used in that way to work out your emotions, your mental health, to stretch your soul a little bit, however you choose to use them, right? So we've been working on the 7 Anishinaabe teachings. We've already covered lesson number 1, as you might remember, the issue of respect which, as we addressed, has to deal with the buffalo. Last week, we were going over the issue of love, which is represented by the eagle. And today we're going over a favorite of mine, lesson number three, or teaching three, and your challenge for the week, right, is to really focus in on your state of courage. So that's teaching three, that to live the good life, you must have courage. And courage is represented, the reason I started with the video up there in the corner there, focusing on one of my bear statues. The bear, Mukwa, is both representative of my clan, and it also, the black bear happens to be my particular spirit guide. So for a variety of reasons, to me, this is a very important one. I mean, they're all important, but this one is personal, right? And so it's the idea of courage. Now, the lessons aren't just individual. There's seven and they tie together. So for instance, you need to have respect for people to then open and listen from the heart. And as you listen from the heart, it will help tell you what is the right thing to do, the right thing to say, the right action to take. And sometimes it takes extreme courage to do the right thing. It'd be easier to hide, to ignore, to slough off, to be lazy, to hurt someone than to help someone. So the lessons all tie together. Courage doesn't just spring up out of the blue. It's not just something you can have without having those other elements of things like respect and love, so that you can listen with your heart and then do not necessarily the easy thing, but the right thing, right? To have the courage to stand up for someone, to have the courage to take that extra effort and do what is right. So that is your challenge for this week, if you're willing to make that stretch, is to find at least one way during the week where instead of following your usual pattern or your usual habit, if you're confronted with a challenge, a sticky situation, a person in a difficult situation, that you have the courage to do the right thing. So, as always, Miigwech, thank you for watching, and I wish for each of us, Jimino Bima Adiziwan, the good life. This was lesson three. There's more to come, and we'll see you next week. Feel free to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Have a great week. Bye.